Hi guys, hello family, welcome to a whole new video, welcome back to my channel. My name is Vimbai. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Today we're going to be talking about planning vacations all in around Zimbabwe. So a disclaimer, I am not a travel agent, I'm not a professional, I'm just going to be telling you guys what I've experienced based on the places that I've gone, the places that I've researched on going, and so I hope you guys find this video informative, and let's get right into it. So I'm going to be talking about the places that I've gone to first and my favorite places, and then I give you guys the course and how you can find out more information, how I found out more information, what was helpful for me, and blah blah blah. So the first thing that we're going to be talking about is how to decide on where you want to go. So for me, I like social media. I'm always on social media. I'm always on Facebook, on Instagram. So yeah, I think this is where I've gotten most of the influence on where to go, because I've seen where everyone else has went, and also following the pages of, you know, accommodation places, of activity places, and different destinations has also given me, like, you know, you see ziplining in Mutarazi, for example, and then you're like, oh, I really want to experience that. So you have to go to Nyanga, and then you find out more and more about Nyanga and so forth. So yeah, I think for me, social media has been what has made me decide where to go most of the time, and also other people's experiences, you know, people that I know, my friends, family. If you see someone's status and you like what you're seeing, just ask, where were you? And that will also help you to make a decision on, oh, I really want to go there. Find out about the costs, find out about what it takes for you to go there, and then decide if you want to go. So yeah, firstly, where to go, other people's experience, social media, adverts. Sometimes, you know how Google search engines work? Like, when you start looking for a destination, for a certain destination, they'll start giving you hints on, or more accommodation options, or more activities options. So based on that, you can really decide. And then the first thing that you have to do after you've found where to go is, now you have to find out more. Like I said, use Google, use Facebook, use Instagram, search Victoria Falls, search Inyangani Mountain, search activities to do in Victoria Falls. You will find a lot of results there, and that will help you to decide, okay, so I would really be interested in doing this, I would really be interested in doing that. So basically, guys, you have to go on the internet to get all this information. Also decide how we are going to be traveling there. This will probably be determined by the distance, and also your budget, and also your pocket. Because say, for example, you want to drive somewhere that's 700 kilometers away, if there is a flight option, you would now have to weigh if that's going to be cheaper for you. It's definitely more convenient, but will it be cheaper, or you are going to take the road trip where you're going to opt for driving yourself there. And then you also have to decide where you're going to stay. You have to find accommodation. I think this is the first thing that you have to do whenever you're going to be planning on going somewhere. First find accommodation, and then activities and whatever, so that at least you have somewhere to stay. You need to have somewhere to stay. You need to have somewhere that's proper, somewhere that you'll be comfortable, because as much as it's just a vacation, it's a few days, I feel like for me, accommodation weighs in a lot. I look at where I'm going to be staying, the proximity of it from activities, the toilets, the how are we going to be getting food, is it self-catering, is it full board, how much is the full board, are you going to be able to afford that? So that's very important. Find out where you would want to be staying. Obviously, you have to find activities as well, which sometimes will be helped when you know where you're going to be staying. Because when you're going to a destination that's a tourist attraction, or, you know, somewhere where people go for holiday, for a lot of times, probably the what's it called, the wherever you're renting or wherever you're going to be staying, they know the activities. that are most common there, and they know who is cheapest and they know who is more reliable, probably they will be the ones who are actually giving those activities. So for example, in Victoria Falls, if you're going to be staying at I'll give an example of when you're staying at local Tula lodges, it's Victoria Falls Safari Hotel. So they have their own chaperoning transport system where they'll take you to your boat cruise, they'll take you to your game drive. They probably have their own game drive, they probably have their own tour guide for the falls. So yeah, deal with wherever you're going to be staying, ask them the activities that are there, ask them what you can do, and next on my list, I have a list that I made. Next, we're going to be talking about budget. Decide on your budget, because as much as we all like to go and have fun and do that, we have to work within some budget. We have to decide we're not going to be spending over $500, we're not going to be spending over $300 on accommodation or on accommodation and activities, or we want to save on accommodation because we want to be out the whole day. So even if we stay somewhere that's not that nice, just as long as it's nice enough, it all just depends. You have to decide on your budget, and you have to make sure that you are within, and whatever you're going to be booking or deciding on doing is within that budget. And then I also think it's very important to get at clothes or outfits that fit the environment that you're going to be going on. So yeah, I remember when I was going to be on safari, I googled like, what do people wear on safari, what am I supposed to have, and I found out you see pictures, look on Pinterest, find out what others are wearing, find out what's in, because you want pictures on your vacations, you want something to remember by, you want to look good, you don't want to feel out of place, because that's very 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 possible, guys. Hey, it's your money, you paid for it, or you are on the safari, but whilst you are with other people, you just want to look presentable. So yeah, look for clothes that will fit the environment and the activities that you're going to be going for. And make sure if you don't have them, buy them, you know. Plan it in time so that you have enough attires. Okay, I think once you've done that, you're good to go, you can enjoy. So like I said, I'm going to be starting with my favorite destinations, going down. So obviously, you know, my favorite in Zimbabwe will be Victoria Falls. So the first time I went to Victoria Falls on my own budget was in 2021, and we used an agent actually to book everything. And guys, I want to tell you, when we went to Victoria Falls, we booked for December for the New Year's holiday, but we started saving in July. We started saving for that trip in July, and we paid for deposit for our accommodation and activities in August, I think. Just the deposit. So yeah, we used an agent when we went, and he handled everything. He paid for our accommodation. We stayed at Lukutula Lodges. We had activities. The activities that we did, that we paid through him, were the boat cruise, which was $40 per person, and had unlimited drinks. This was really nice. Like, we had drinks the whole 2 hours. You could have as much as you could. So that was really nice. And we also got the Boma dinner and drum show, which is something you should never miss when you go to Victoria Falls. It was $45 per person. It's a buffet. It's dinner. That's a buffet. You eat all you can. And then there's a drum show where everyone gets their own little drum. And then you're playing along to the beat. There's someone who is telling you how to play, and it's fun, it's enjoyable. I liked it. I hope I can insert one or two, you know, videos and pictures as I go. And then for the falls, we didn't opt for a guide in the falls. We just went there alone. We saw the falls on our own. You can get a guide if you want to know the history behind living. So the did this and that day, those are the cataract falls, those are what this is the eighth point. You know, if you want someone to tell you all that, it's very possible to get yourself a guide, but we thought it was unnecessary, and you know, we also wanted our own time together, so we did not opt for a guide when we did Victoria Falls. For accommodation, we stayed there for 4 nights, I think 3 or 4 nights, I don't remember. It was $300 for the two of us, but we shared a chalet. It was a two-bedroom chalet, and we shared with one of my husband's friends, so that made it more affordable. Also, we shared also on the fuel. So yeah, if you can carpool and if you can share the chalet, it's all the better. Also, other activities that you can do in Victoria Falls, you can do game drive. I think it's around from $40 per person, 50-60, it just depends on which company you are using. And also, you can do the drive on your own if you've got a good vehicle. I think it's $5 to get into the national park. What else can you do? You can do the crocodile farm. There's bungee jumping. And I'm not an adrenaline person, guys, so I have no idea of the price of those. You can do ziplining. You can do white water rafting. People do that, black people even. And you can do what else? I was thinking about something else. There's a lot that you can do anyways. How do you find this out? Google, search on Facebook, ask your whoever is giving you accommodation, or if you're going to be going the guide way like we did, like the agent way like we did. I would advise you guys not to do agents unless I advise to use agents unless, let's say right now we're in September and you want to go on a holiday in December, you definitely need an agent, because I don't know what strings they pull, but they can get you bookings even when you're late. I remember for our honeymoon, which I'm going to be talking about next, we booked it like late October, I think, and we still got a place because we booked it through an agent. So I think if you're late and you really, really want to go in December, you need to use an agent, because you probably find that all the places will say we're fully booked, especially during Christmas and New Year, we're fully booked. So if you want to get on those time slots, you're probably going to need to engage an agent. So yeah, engage an agent if you're late, but if you're not, I think it's more affordable and definitely a better experience if you set things up yourself. You're assured that you will have the accommodation that you need. Not to discredit him or anything, in the end we had a really nice day, but for when we did our Victoria Falls trip, we had booked to stay at Shearwater, but he said that there was, he didn't tell us when we got there is when he told us that unfortunately I couldn't secure Shearwater, so now you're going to be having to stay at Loktula. And Loktula wasn't bad, but you know, when you go there and you know I'm going to be staying at Shearwater, you look at pictures, you look at what you've prepared yourself. So yeah, in a way I did like it. I was mad, but then he took us to dinner that night at Victoria Falls Hotel, which was nice. So we forgave him, and he was a good guy. What? Anyways, I'm just saying, if you can plan things yourself, especially locally, guys, I think you can do it yourself. I said only engage an agent if you can no longer find accommodation. They have strings, they pull. I don't know what it is, but they make things happen. Anyways, let's move on to the next destination, Kariba. I had been to Kariba once before, but it was a school trip, and it was so hot. It was really, really hot. I didn't like the experience, but then when I went for our honeymoon, I really liked it. There isn't so much activity to do in Kariba. The dam is like, yeah, there's no water in there anymore. There's, you know, from the time that I first went and then the time that I went last year, it's very different. Right now there is not much water in the dam, because that was something you'd actually enjoy doing, just going and sightseeing at the dam and doing a nice tour and all. So what we did when we went to Kariba, we did quad bikes. I think they were $20 per person, if I'm not mistaken, and it was for like 30 minutes. It was a long trail. I remember when we went to Kumusha with my auntie, the trail was the trail was very short. It was just $5, I guess. But I wasn't really excited about the one at Kumusha, but it went over the beach and around the lake. I enjoyed the ride. So definitely do quad biking in Kariba. And then we also did a boat cruise, which was I think $30 or $35 per person. This one it didn't have unlimited drinks, but it was still fun. And they had a guide that taught us about Kariba and how low the water is, like how bad it is, and which was really interesting. I think that's always very interesting. I think the best thing about that trip was our accommodation, because we were just coming from our wedding. We were really tired and we told ourselves we're just going to have a proper vacation, like we're just going to rest. We weren't really about the activities, but you know, we were there for like 5 days, so we told ourselves we need to squeeze in at least one or two activities into this. We can't be, you know, laying around all of these days. But yeah, the accommodation was the best part for me. We stayed at Kariba Safari Lodges, which was very luxurious, and we paid $119 per person on full board, which meant we got breakfast, we got lunch, and we got supper at the hotel. And I really enjoyed that part, guys. I think if you can always do full board, unless in Victoria Falls when you have activities, and because sometimes you get carried away at activities, especially if there's no time. So yeah, if you're just there to lay around, lazy around, please consider doing full board. For me, that was very luxurious. So Kariba was nice. It was hot, but they had air conditioning, they had a nice pool. It was one of the best places that I've ever stayed. So next we're going to talk about Nyanga. Unfortunately, I have no idea how much it is, because my sister and her husband took us. It was on their expense. I was working, but I was a spoiled class one on that trip, so I didn't pay anything. I have no idea how much they paid, but I know, like from research now, that Blue Swallow Lodges at Troutbeck, they are pretty affordable for 6 people. I think, I don't remember, I think it was 140 for a lodge with is it a 2-bed or 3-bed? I don't remember, but somewhere there. And if you just search Blue Swallow Lodges right now, guys, you'll get all of this information, especially if you like Facebook like me. You'll get all this information, probably get a contact that you can WhatsApp or call and get all the details that you want. And also in Nyanga, I've realized that they have a lot of holiday homes that are probably more ideal for group settings. For example, I know this holiday home that's $180 per night for 8 people, which is pretty affordable in my opinion, because you're paying like what, $20-$25 per person. I don't know the math, but somewhere there per night, which is really, really reasonable. So again, going on a vacation in a group setting is makes things more affordable. You're going to be able to carpool, you're going to be able to save on fuel, you're going to be able to stay in one place that's going to be cheaper. So yeah, I know that in Kariba you have, sorry, in Nyanga you have Mutarazi Skywalk, you have the zip line, you have a lot of waterfalls. I think we went to 2, I don't remember what they were. And then you have natural pools, and obviously you also have quad bikes. And then there's the view, what's it called, World's View. I've actually never been there at World's View. I think we passed there late at night. What I did was hiking Mount Nyangani, guys. It was I don't know, I've sworn that I want to do it again, but now I'm thinking maybe I will, I don't know. But if you like hiking and you like fitness things and you just want to prove a point, it's a very nice way to do it. It's a long walk. I think we walked for like 3 hours to and 3 hours back. Am I lying? I don't remember. 4 hours to and fro, I don't know, but it was long and I got sunburned. Maybe I won't go back, I don't know. Anyways, that's Nyanga for you. Nyanga for me, I really like the scenery. Like when you're driving to Nyanga, guys, the green, the trees, it's just a very beautiful view. And I think that's what you're looking for when you're going on vacation. You want to escape the dust, you want to escape the tar in Harare, you want to escape work, you want to escape what and what. And I think that's a very nice place to go. Talking about views, we will move on to Vumba. Vumba, again, I went there for my birthday. I think it was 2021. I don't remember. We went for my birthday with my mom and my sister, and the views are to die for as well. Whilst you're driving through, it's something that you've never ever seen before. It's like a rainforest. I don't know what to call it, but Vumba is very, very beautiful. There are also a lot of cottages, hidden cottages there and there that you can look for and try and inquire and visit. When we went to Vumba after Nyanga, we stayed at Musangano Lodge, which is very nice, guys. I like the place, it's very nice. I think the accommodation right now was, they also do chalets. I think it was 170 for a two-bedroom chalet, 140 for a one-bed chalet. But it's nice, it had bed and breakfast, I think. And now I know they have hotel rooms that are newly built, so that's again another option. You can do Nyanga for like half of your vacation and then finish in Vumba. And if you cannot find accommodation in Vumba, you can stay in Musangano, because Musangano is like 10 kilometers from Mutare. I'm not sure about the distance, but it's a very, very short drive from Mutare, so you'd be in Mutare and pretty close to Vumba. So for Vumba, you can do the botanical garden, very beautiful and dreamy. You can do Tony's Cafe, a nice cake. I know people fly helicopters there to Harare to buy cake. Yeah. And then you can do Leopard Rock for lunch. You can do Leopard Rock for lunch. And then there are a lot of waterfalls there as well that I don't know, guys. I've never been to those waterfalls, so I don't know. I can't tell you or how much they are. But yeah, they also have beautiful cottages. And definitely for Vumba, you can definitely look for B&Bs. In Vumba, on Kuku, you will find a lot of options. You will find something that's probably within your budget, and yeah, you can enjoy. So guys, I think I've covered those four corners. Oh, there is Binga. So for Binga, I've been to Binga, but I was in high school, it was a school trip. All I know is that the road is pretty bad. It's bad, and there are steep mountains, so you'll be having to be going up. So consider that when you're choosing your vehicle as well. But I know that there is a beach and they have beautiful views because the Zambezi passes through. So yeah, I've never really wanted to go because of the road and stuff. But yeah, you can try Binga as well if you're close, or if you want the long road trip, you can try Binga. Unfortunately, our tourism, all our tourist attractions in Zimbabwe, Vic Falls is a bad road. From Blawayo to Vic Falls, it's bad. From Kariba, again, Chinoe Kariba is bad. From Binga, again, Binga is bad. I don't know why things are like that, but yeah, the roads are bad, guys. When we went to Victoria Falls the last time, like 2 months ago, we lost two tires. Like, we had to buy two new tires. We lost them like completely. So yeah, be prepared for that whilst you're budgeting. Make sure you put in a few cents for emergencies, for if we lose a tire, we're gonna need to buy another one to be able to come back home. What if we lose another one on our way back? We're going to need money to buy probably two new tires. So yeah, factor that in. So for these places that I've mentioned, I think I've told you guys before, Victoria Falls, please don't go there for just a weekend. It's such a beautiful place, you won't have enough time in 2 days. Let's do four and more, you know, Vic Falls, Kariba, Nyanga, Vumba. So now I just want to talk about I'm calling them hidden gems, like places where you can go for your weekend getaway. If you don't want to do like the long 4 days and you want to be back home, I'm going to be talking about my favorite places that I've gone to for weekends and that I would want to go to for weekends. So the first one will be Bushman Rock, obviously. Bushman Rock Safaris. I really, really thoroughly enjoyed myself on this, when we went for this weekend away. It was sort of like for my birthday, but it was a very, very early birthday present that my husband got for me. But yeah, it was $90 per person, bed and breakfast. And then firstly, you can also do just a day trip for this. We went for one night. We just made sure we went early. So we went there around 7, 8 a.m. So we got there, we were able to do their game drive. We did a picnic, our own picnic, and then we did the game drive later on after lunch. And then we came back, chilled for a bit, and we did supper, and then woke up and left. So the accommodation was really nice. Not really, it was nice. The accommodation was nice. I felt like the room we got was pretty ancient. I did a video on the Bushman Rock experiences there on my channel, and I felt as if our room wasn't the best, but it was pretty secluded and nice. It was nice. And then they also have River Thames. I don't know if we pay the same price. Unfortunately, I didn't check. I know I have the whatever document somewhere when they sent me, when I made an inquiry and wanted to go, but I didn't look for it. So it was $90 a person bed and breakfast, and then the activities that are there, like I said, they can set up a picnic for you by the lake, by the river. It's nice. We saw the little whatever picnic place that they put their guests. It was nice. I would go, but I think it was like $90 for the picnic. And then so we did our own picnic. We carried our baskets. And then we just had a good time. We chatted, blah blah blah. And then there are zebras everywhere. Zebras everywhere. There is wildlife around, so that also makes it, you know, a safari kind of feeling. And then they also have wine tasting. Unfortunately, when we went, the person who does wine tasting wasn't there, so we weren't able to do that. But yeah, probably everyone who has gone to Bushman Rocks has done wine tasting. And then they also have a game drive, and you can actually see a lot of animals. We saw wild beasts, we saw giraffes, we saw ostriches. Do you know that ostriches can run very fast? I don't remember the distance that he told us, but it was a lot. What else did we see? I don't remember. Guys, go and watch the video. You'll see everything that we did at Bushman Rock. And then they also have a nature walk. If you know, like I said, if you're into the hiking and walking and fitness, what you'll probably like the nature walk. And then they also have a pontoon ride, which was my favorite. We had a pontoon breakfast, which is like a little boat. You're floating on the boat while you're having breakfast, or you can also do it at lunch or dinner. I think they were saying they were about to set up lights so that people can have dinner on the pontoon. It's a very nice experience, guys. I think it was $20 a person. So we paid $40 for the two of us. And then the game drive as well, was it $10 per person. The activities at Bushman Rock were not expensive at all, pretty affordable. And again, you can do a day trip at Bushman Rock, as long as you just book in time. And then another place that we went was Antelope Park is close to my heart, because that's where my husband proposed and I said yes. So they have pretty nice accommodation. They have sort of like River Thames as well, the ones that they have at Bushman Rock. Unfortunately, we didn't sleep there. We just went for a day trip. We ended up staying in Gweru at one of the B&Bs. So we did Antelope Park. They have they have game drive. They have what's it called, the elephant encounter, which is what we did and when my husband proposed. And then they also do lunch. Then they, what else is there? don't remember, guys. I think there's lion encounter. If I'm not mistaken, they might have something with lions, but we end up not doing all of that. I was just too excited and calling an end. Anyway, I'm going off topic. So yeah, Antelope Park is really nice. The accommodation is probably 90 per person, I think. Antelope Park's prices are always all over the place. If you just look Antelope Park, if you just search Instagram or Facebook, you will definitely find their prices and decide if you want to go. There's also Matopo Hills. Matopo Hills is where Midlands, they're about. I'm not sure, is it after Gweru? I don't know, somewhere there. There is Matopo Hills. It's also very nice. They also have very nice accommodation, a nice pool. You know, they have there is Matopo Hills where you can go and look at the hills and someone's grave is there. Is it whose grave is there? I don't know. Some white guy who colonized us. His grave is there. So people go and see the grave. So yeah, I think you can go there. I like the accommodation. It looks very nice and clean, and like I would enjoy this. They also have a nice pool. I think one of those prices, Emma, 119.90 per person, 129 full board, somewhere there about. Again, Matopo Hills, the prices are always there, guys. If you just go on their pages, you'll find the price. And then there's also Chengeta and Pamzinda lodges. My sister went here. I've never been. They have beautiful accommodation. I think 119-129 per person with bed and breakfast and full board, if I'm not mistaken. Then they have game drives, they have horse riding, they have canoe ride. I don't want to talk much about places where I've not been in case I mislead you guys. But again, if you go on their pages, you definitely find a contact to call. You definitely find someone to talk to and ask or make inquiries about all these things. Then there's also Mutorashanga. Mutorashanga, guys, for me was so underwhelming when I went because I was expecting, I don't know. Yes, there's blue water, but that's it. So maybe if you wanna, you know, just go out for a day and enjoy with your friends, you could probably do Mutorashanga. Then people also go to Mazoe Dam for braai. They also go to what's it called, Koneka Mota. I don't know, I've never been. They're about doing day trips. So yeah, I think I've talked about all the things that I wanted to talk about. I hope I didn't leave anything out. Just research, guys, on what you want. Research on where you want to go, how much you're willing to spend, and yeah, make a date. Even if you start saving now, I know in January, February, they're about prices for holidays will be slashed because people will be back at work. The festive season will be done. You can probably save, and if you start saving now in September, you'll probably get there by January, February, and just go and spoil yourselves, go and have a good time, make it a girls trip, make it a fun couples trip, make it a family trip, whatever you wanna do that. And yeah, I think you guys will really find that you enjoy vacationing and it becomes a nice hobby. I also wanted to talk about payments. Like, you have to make deposits. Please be careful not to just send deposits to whoever you don't know. Most places now, they want you to actually go into the bank and deposit your cash, or if you have a Nostro account, to do the transfer and then send them the proof of payment. That is only when they will secure your booking. So yeah, be advised on that. You probably, if you don't have a Nostro account, you probably need to physically go to the bank to deposit the money. So yeah, call, make sure you understand, make sure you get in tune with the terms that they are offering, what they are saying you'll be getting on the money that you've paid, so that there are no misunderstandings. Go for the thrill, go for the nice activities, make sure you check out everything. And yeah, I hope you guys plan your vacation. Guys, if you feel like, oh, I don't want to do it, oh, I'm too lazy, please DM me on my Instagram. I'm very, very happy to help. I will be very, very happy to plan your vacations for you. For if you don't know, maybe I'll be a travel agent soon. So yeah, if you feel like, no, I want to plan this and that, but I don't know where to start, please DM me and I'll take your money and I'll plan a holiday for you. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. And yeah guys, before I go, I just want to say I have not been getting a lot of time to vlog. I've been at work has been, you know, so yeah, I really sat down to make this video because I was like, no, it's been too long, it's been 2 weeks already. So I'm gonna be MIA for a bit, but I'll be back. Thank you guys for watching. Still, you're watching the old videos, people are subscribing even though there are no new videos, and I'm so grateful. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.